Hey everyone, as you know, earlier this year, Wise Magazine had their lawyers pressure Patreon to remove my account. This shut down my YouTube channel for 2 months while I struggled to get a new funding source. This is quite difficult for Chinese nationals. The things that seem like easy solutions, cryptocurrencies or PayPal, these are not practical for a number of reasons. I understand if you don't see it, but trust me, I have put hundreds of hours into researching options. There are many. Finally, last May, I started using Subscribestar. Back then, there was only one or two other creators on the site, just cosplayers. For the past few months, I have struggled to get back on my feet. My income is still half of what it was before Wise came to China, broke a written agreement, and put me in danger. They never have to answer for that. Only me. It's been quite difficult. I don't regret it though. One day, I will be able to show everything that happened and everyone will see I only did what I have to. These people, they're evil. I only have a local Chinese education. I'm very good in math, science, physics. I did well in Chinese history. I was the top English student in my district. I still have my trophies. The last few years, I've tried very hard to educate myself on social issues, but it is not where I'm strongest. Most of these things are private matters in China, so I can't really say I'm an expert in this situation, but what I see makes no sense. This week, some people who say things that other people don't like came to my founding platform, Subscribestar. Now, those offended people want to take away my livelihood. They want to stop Subscribestar from funding anyone. I'm supposed to be sacrificed for their politics? Again? For their fight? I'm just a girl in China. Why me? Why not sacrifice their income if they feel so strongly? Why are they doing this? Supposedly to save people like me. It makes no sense. This is the third time something like this is happening in about a year. So I know no help is coming from the West. I'm a foreigner. I know no help is coming from China. I'm doing something I should not. Even when the New York Times stole my videos and used them without attribution in a very nasty, mean-spirited way, no one in the media would say anything. I wanted to fight, but I don't have the resources. Last time I tried to fight for myself, look what Vice did. As a Chinese citizen, I risk a lot to post my videos on YouTube. To steal them like that? I lost so much respect then. They talked all about ethics, but in the end, they were cowards. No one who claims to be any kind of respectable journalist can stand by and watch something like that happen. I know that I look strange. I don't explain my background, my childhood, why as soon as I became an adult, I choose to look the way I do, because I don't think anyone should have to explain their appearance. I think just wanting to look very girlish is not so bad. It's a very small quirk that should not make people so angry. I look funny. I present my work in a fun way so people smile and don't think tech is boring. But my work is good and I'm not hurting anyone. But I look different than other women in technology and that means I stand alone. Okay, I accept that's my price to pay. If I wanted, otherwise I could conform, just like them. Color my hair like them, only have the same opinions as them. I don't. I think it's better to pay the price and be myself. So I will pay the price again. Probably they will win again, take away most of my income again. They will try to discredit me and my work again. They have no principles. They don't care who they hurt. I've seen it too many times now to doubt it. I will try to keep things running smoothly, but if I can't, that is what is going on. I'm a hard worker and I'll keep doing that. Thank you for your patience.